A town in Oriental Mindoro is placed under a state of calamity due to the extreme effect of El Nino. The provincial government earlier said the dry spell already cost about 75 million pesos in damage to rice and onion crops in the town of Bulalacao. Meanwhile, in Look, Occidental Mindoro, some 200 hectares of farm have also been damaged. Officials of these two towns are appealing for help from the national government. A bid to increase farm productivity, the Philippine Agriculture Department has turned to, get this, space technology. The DA and the Philippine Space Agency, or PhilSA, inked a deal to modernize data collection, analysis, and dissemination, fostering informed decision-making and sustainable growth in the agriculture and fisheries sector. The partnership will utilize space tech, remote sensing, and sophisticated agricultural systems to drive innovation and efficiency in the sector. The project will be pilot tested in Nueva Ecija Town. Now, Agriculture Secretary Tio Laurel says embracing technological advances is crucial in addressing the problems faced by the industry. Philippine Agriculture Chief vows to continue efforts to modernize the country's farming sector. Secretary Francisco Tio Laurel Jr. spoke at a February 20 gathering of the United Nations Food and Agriculture Organization in Sri Lanka. Laurel says the agency will ramp up investments in science-based technologies to increase farmers' income and produce competitive output. DA will also seek to increase the country's capacity to utilize agricultural data to help food security and poverty alleviation. On climate change, Laurel says there must be greater cooperation in the Asia-Pacific region to mitigate its impact on nations' agri-food systems. Our next guest today is the mayor of Nunungan, Lanao del Norte, where Mount Inayawan Range Natural Park, an ASEAN Heritage Park, is located. Now, the park is declared as the 53rd ASEAN Heritage Park last year. And today on the show, Mayor Marcos Mamay gives us a glimpse of what has changed in the southern town after the declaration, especially in the field of tourism. Mayor Mamay, welcome to the Business Roadshow.
Thank you, sir.
Good afternoon.
And I would like to take this opportunity to thank your team for having this opportunity to hear our concern.
All right.
On what is happening in the municipality of Nunungan.
All right. It's good to talk about this. This is a major achievement. In fact, this is a recognition of the ASEAN Heritage Park, being 53rd ASEAN Heritage Park. It has been declared that Mount Inayawan Range Natural Park is recognized for its ecological value. Tell us what this recognition means to you and your people.
Actually, having this recognition is a great opportunity. It's a great honor. But also, it comes with a great responsibility. So not every municipality, not every city can have this responsibility, this recognition. But however, we have to sustain, we have to protect our natural resources. Otherwise, especially those in the coastal areas, then they are very pitiful, because knowing the fact that Nunungan serve as the waterhead of the Kapatagan Valley. So we have to preserve what we have in Nunungan.
All right. And so far, this has a lot of potential in terms of tourism. Tell us about it. Are people now, more people now trying to visit the area because of the recognition?
So first of all, sir, I would like to take this opportunity to mention some of the potentials that we have in the municipality of Nunungan. We have three lakes. We have four waterfalls. And we have five caves. Then we have this very famous in Nunungan. We have this wild berries. That hopefully will become the wild berries capital in the whole Philippines.
Okay, we're looking at videos, in fact, of the place. This is Nunungan. Can you describe to us the topography of the area and what makes it, a good place to visit if you are looking for different kinds of adventure, whether it's water-based or if you want to go mountain climbing or food?
Yes, Nunungan. Actually, Nunungan, very potential when it comes to ecotourism in the whole province of Lanao del Norte. So we have, again, we have this lake. We have three lakes. Then this is the highest mountain in the whole province of Lanao del Norte. Then actually, we have many potentials that we have in Nunungan. Again, we have four waterfalls. We have five caves also. Okay. Then now we have established our strawberry farm in Nunungan.
Right.
Because
I didn't even know that this is called the raspberry capital of the Philippines.
Yes, actually, aside from raspberry, we have this strawberry farm.
Okay.
Then we also have the grapes and also the dragon fruit. So knowing the fact that Nunungan is a very has a very fertile soil, so all types of crops is good in Nunungan.
All right. What about access to Nunungan now? How does one get there? Supposing you come from Manila, how do you get to Lanao del Norte?
For those who come from Luzon, there are three options. Either from Manila to Cagayan de Oro, or Manila to Usami City, or Manila to Pagadian City. But the nearest one is Pagadian, where it takes only 1 hour from Pagadian to the municipality of Nunungan.
Okay, tell us now about the infrastructure, particularly tourism infrastructure in the area. Are there hotels available, and what are the activities that one can do when visiting the area?
Actually, Nunungan, knowing the fact that Nunungan has been deprived for peace and development for the past decades, or to be exact, 30 long years that Nunungan has been deprived for such. So now, since my assumption, we had this realization of 1.5 worth of concreting, connecting the three municipalities in the province of Lanao del Norte, in the municipality of Salvador, to Nunungan, down to Sultanaga de Mapuro. That is amounting to 1.5 billion. Then also this, that is for the accessibility. And then next, we have this electrification. So that is amounting to 68 million. So when it comes to peace and order, so generally peaceful, the municipality of Nunungan nowadays. So we don't have to worry when it comes to peace and order, because the stability is there.
Okay. And what are the programs now, the existing programs of the local government to promote this area?
Actually, when it comes to programs, we have so many projects that the government is being extending in the municipality of Nunungan. So there are many infrastructure projects, knowing the fact that Nunungan possesses the largest land area in the whole province of Lanao del Norte. So what we need primarily is mostly farm-to-market road, accessibility, connecting all the barangay so that we'll be able to transport the products and services in each barangay.
All right. And so far, the challenge has been, of course, you've mentioned infrastructure. Peace and order is okay, and you have a great offer in terms of the destination and the sites and points of interest that one can visit in Nunungan. Perhaps you'd like to invite our audience to go and see your place.
Yes, Luzon Business Mindanao. This is a sort of promotion, and at the same time, this is to invite everyone to visit Nunungan, knowing, as I said earlier, Nunungan is very potential when it comes to ecotourism. In fact, most of the celebrities come to Nunungan just to visit Nunungan because of its nice, it's a nice place. In fact, the movie that I have, it has been shot in Nunungan. That is, I would like also to take this opportunity, because I've been mentioned regarding with the movie, that is Mamay, the Great Man of Nunungan, starring Jerry Crabal, Aramina, Polo Rabales, Victor Neri, T.J. Marquez, and some other celebrities.
All right. I'm sure that will be a great avenue to promote Nunungan town in Lanao del Norte. Again, Nunungan Mayor Marcos Mamay, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you also.
Have a good day.
You're welcome, sir. Thank you so much.